ASMR.
Hello there. Happy Sunday. Welcome to Letitia's Voice. And welcome back to my channel. So again, happy Sunday. Glad to be back. Last week was relaxation day. And sorry I couldn't get to you to do a video, but I did have a really accomplished week. I hope you did too. But I'm back today, and what I want to do for you is be your angel today. Is be an angel today. And so I'm here to be your angel. Let's go ahead and get started with our lippy color. Today's color is called You Dig by Fenty Beauty. And as you can see, we're going pretty bold today. So again, this is Letitia's Voice, and I am your angel for today. So tell me what it is that you need. If you need me to be a listening ear, I can be a listening ear for you. But during this time, I just want you to relax and let me know what you need. It'll be just between you and me. This is also a blue moon this evening. So from what I was reading, not only is it the moon time for manifesting, but it's also time for releasing. So if there's anything in your life, anyone in your life, that you need to release because they're causing you too much stress, or they're toxic to you, or they're harmful to you physically, mentally, or emotionally, it's okay to let them go. I know it's cliche, but there's a reason why we hear the saying, people are here in your life for Unfortunately, everybody's not meant to be in our lives forever. That can be very harmful. I mean, that can be very hurtful. But sometimes it's necessary to let go. So what's on your mind? I can do all that. One, I can give you encouragement. You can do whatever it is you set your mind to do. If there's a goal that you want to achieve, write it down and make it happen. You can do it. If you want to go to school or go back to school, or learn a new trade, or learn how to do something new online, you can do it all. There's resources available for you out there. Also, if you've ever been hurt, abused, I just want you to know, it's not your fault. It's not your It's not your fault. It's not your fault. It's not your fault. And you are not alone. Are not alone. I'm a big advocate of finding support groups for whatever it is that you're going through. If you've been dealing with a narcissist or you've dealt with a narcissist, there's a group for that. Other survivors, other thrivers, people who have gotten out of those relationships, those who may still be in but just need a little bit more encouragement. But you do not have to stay in an abusive relationship, in an abusive friendship, or even in an abusive family. You matter. What you think matters. How you feel about yourself matters. And you know, here, we always look to the place of healing. In here, we're always looking for a place where we can feel better about ourselves. Not just because want to feel better about ourselves, but because that's our God-given right to feel good about ourselves, to live our best lives, and to be our best selves. Now, I know I'm being an angel for you today, but if you wouldn't mind being an angel for me for a moment, and if you like what you've heard so far, or you like being here with me on Sundays, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. I really appreciate that. It really helps out my channel, and it allows for me to be able to know that what it is that you want me to bring to you every week. Complimenting you too. You know, I think we all like compliments. Everybody always likes to hear something positive about themselves that somebody else notices. I remember every single time, and really any man I've ever encountered, but I remember my dad was so cute. Whenever he'd get a new haircut, I always made a big deal about it. Oh, daddy, you got a new haircut. You got a haircut. He was so proud of his haircut. But compliments make us feel good. So who doesn't want a compliment? So, you are looking a new hairdo. It looks great on you. I love that tie. Wow, I love your dress. Are those new shoes? They look so cute with that outfit. You know, I've always admired your wisdom. You know, you're the smartest one in the class, and I've always admired that. Wow. You always do a great job, and I look up to you. You're the best one on the team. Wow, you've read that many books. You are so smart. You always know the right answers. Oh, and you always know the right thing to say. I love hearing you talk about your favorite subject. You're always so passionate about it. I appreciate you telling me your story. You encourage me so much. Hey, the tip you gave me, it worked wonders. You were right. It worked out exactly how you said it would. You gave the perfect advice. I love the relationship you have with your children. You can tell they love you very much. I admire the fun relationship you have with your siblings. You always look like you guys are having a great time. You make the best apple pie. It's so delicious. That recipe you gave me was absolutely perfect for my dinner party. You're so good at those recipes. Thank you. And another thing before, I know again I'm playing angel today, but I want to tell you some of the things that you can do if you ever want to play angel to somebody else. You know you can do your random acts of kindness any day of the week. And I know we don't talk a lot about money here on this channel, but let's talk about things surrounding money. Forgive the traffic. But you want to do something randomly nice? Pay for a cup of coffee for someone else. Pay for the car behind you in the drive-thru. Here's one thing that I do all the time. I believe that whenever you give a wallet or a purse of some sort to a person, you always stick money inside. So the next time, try that next time. Whenever you're going to give somebody a purse, a wallet, or something that carries money, put some money in it to get them started. What other random acts of kindness can you do surrounding money? Obviously, you can give it away to people you see maybe on the street. You can also donate money to worthy causes, your favorite charities, or any children's organization. Those are all ways to use your money wisely and for a great cause. Another thing you can do is, if a person is sick, you can make them some soup. Can cook their dinner for a week. Somebody's not feeling well. You know, you could do meal prep. You can drop off your leftovers, or not picked over leftovers, but if you have leftover items in your cupboard, you can consider donating them to a shelter or to a food bank, or to one of those commodities places that give out food. You can donate food to them as well. You can decide to take your friend's group out for dinner, and you pick up the tab. Or just randomly saying, hey, asking a coworker or a friend you haven't seen in a really long time to go out to lunch. There's so many ways. And don't forget that elderly people in your neighborhoods and in your community, they have the Meals on Wheels program. Just maybe you want to take over to your elderly neighbor, maybe some cookies or something you baked. That's a nice random act of kindness. And also, sometimes people just need you to be there for them. Not to say anything necessarily, but to just be a listening ear. And sometimes you may have to just give them a little tissue. So here's one for you. Sometimes people just need a friend. They don't want you to say anything. They don't want your advice. They don't want any judgment. They just want you to listen. Just listen to their stories with patience and without judgment. If they need to complain, let them complain. If they need to vent, let them vent. If they need to cry, let them cry. If they need to yell, let them yell. Not at you, at the situation. And just be a friend. Just be someone's angel. So again, I thank you for being here. And I ask you to please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Happy Sunday to you from your angel. Have a good week.